riches have leaked to leakage. I think they will find that Sabah has produced among the richest politicians in the country. That's not the whole purpose of the economic development in Sabah. The whole purpose of economic development in Sabah must be to produce among the, no, to distribute wealth, development, and ensure distribution of wealth among the people of Sabah, to ensure that there is no more poverty in Sabah. In fact, there should not be poverty by 2000 in Sabah. Instead, we have the Sabah, the poorest state. So we press. We are pressing on in our call for a Royal Commission inquiry, especially with 50th year of Sabah and Sarawak in the Malaysia. Because we do not want, when it comes to 2013, 50th year anniversary of Sabah and Sarawak in Malaysia, that the Sabah is even poorer because of the hijacking of the work by the politically powerful group of people who continue to enjoy the work of Sabah's development. On the other hand, I think the Sabah State Government, the State Assembly is meeting, must be able to give a proper response to this report, World Bank report, and not just denial. This is denial syndrome on the part of Ismail, just deny, after Nasruddin has already admitted. And I call on the Sabah State Government to come up to full support our Royal Commission inquiry. Why the Sabah people are so poor as a whole, Sarawak. And I call on all Barisan Nasional MPs. I mean, we are present, the Pakatan Rakyat, we have one MP from Sabah. I mean, you cannot decide on establishing a Royal Commission inquiry. But if all the Sabah members of Parliament agree that there should be a Royal Commission inquiry into the 5 decades of Sabah and Sarawak in Malaysia and why things went wrong, why the people as a whole have not benefited, although a small group have benefited, I don't think the federal government and the Prime Minister Najib can ignore it. If all the Barisan and all the MPs in Sabah, regardless of party, come out and take a united stand, and all the assemblymen, Sabah Assembly, to united stand that there should be a Royal Commission inquiry. What went wrong? How can we ensure that there is a equitable, sustainable, inclusive growth for the next 10, 20 years? The federal government can ignore it. It must set up a Royal Commission inquiry. So, Jimmy will be raising the issue in the Sabah State Assembly. We call on all members of parliament from Sabah to support this call. And because with one MP from KK, we cannot decide on this matter. But as I said, now it's all in the hands of the MPs and the state assemblymen in Sabah, whether they can stand united for the people of Sabah to call for a Royal Commission inquiry. Get a World Bank to come in and support. Let a World Bank send a representative on this Royal Commission inquiry, because I think the people of Sabah has had a raw deal long enough. Okay, any questions? You?
That's okay.
Okay? You saw what you have?
Okay, I have one statement to add up on the cross.
Okay.
My conclusion about all why Sabah become the poorest state in Malaysia.
I think the first thing is you must have chief ministers, you must have political state ministers who must be committed to ensure that the wealth of Sabah goes to people of Sabah and not to themselves. I think that's the first step. You must not have seen, you know, Sabah producing among the richest politicians. I think if that first guideline can be ensured, I think a new beginning, an example will be set that politics is service to people and not the service to self.
Mechanism will be used.
Mechanism will be. No, all the wealth and resources will be towards the betterment of the people. You don't have situation of the Orungus or Orang Sungai having higher percentage. I mean, all Sabahans, all of us benefit equitably.
Yeah. We have repeatedly saying that because we think Sabah actually, East Malaysia actually contributed a lot of natural gas and also oil to the national income. To the national income, actually, the figure is like Sabah and Sarawak contributed 44.5% in terms of the crude oil and also 46.1% of the natural gas production in the country. And therefore, actually, we have promised that if we Pakatan Raya we take over the federal government, we will increase the oil royalty from the currently 5% to 20%. Because we think Sabahan and also Sarawakian, they deserve it. They deserve it. And we believe that by increasing the oil royalty, it will actually benefit the Sabahan and Sarawakian. And also, if I may add on, another evidence to show that Sabah and Sarawak has all the while been marginalized by the federal government, by the DM government, is like even for the budget 2011, you look at all the major projects mentioned by the Prime Minister's speech. All together, you can see the specific projects. The projects that is located in West Malaysia amounted to about 109.74 billion. But however, only for Sabah and Sarawak is only like how much? 9.55 billion. That is about 8% of the total value of these major projects mentioned in the budget 2011. So it's another piece of evidence saying that even though Sabah is the poorest state in Malaysia, but yet the resources are not coming to Sabah and Sarawak to help the Sabah and Sarawak to develop.
And the change of system is important, because otherwise, for instance, even if the Basan National Government agrees to change, to increase oil royalty from 5% to 20%, it's not the people who will benefit. It will be the, you go into private pockets.
What would the Royal Commission inquiry do?
I think into all aspects as to why. All aspects, political, educational, the getting out, the stone,
Atau Sumpah,
the three pledges, you know, on Tanah, Adat, and Agama. Why have that been upheld? Why the people are discontent? Why there is unhappiness? Why there is all aspects of it? All aspects, political, economic, educational, cultural, why Sabahan? Why there is such a great migration of the Sabah talents? A lot of people Sabah must go to Peninsula, go over the world to seek jobs. A whole total top to bottom review.
Normally,
who would do it? It'll be a federal government with agreement of the state government and inviting international experts, including World Bank. It's an independent body, yeah. What went wrong? Why the people, hopes of the early generations, early forefathers of Sabahans and Sarawakians in agreeing to the formation of Malaysia, that Sabah can be as developed as Peninsula Malaysia, were not fulfilled. All aspects.